In this video, we're going to look at how we can change the name of a shortcut, as well as the color and the icon that is associated with that shortcut. We're going to look at this on the Mac, iPad, and iPhone. Let's first look at this on my Mac. So I'm in my Shortcuts app here, and when I look at any one of these shortcuts, you're going to see that there are three attributes. Let's take a look at this shortcut here. We can see the name, Take Break, and then we can also see that it has an orange color, and there's a little timer icon in the upper left-hand corner. We can change all of these attributes, the name, color, and that icon. The way that we change that is we edit the shortcut. How do we do that on a Mac? All we have to do is just double-click on it. So I double-click on it, and I can edit the shortcut. Let's first look at how we change the name. To change the name, what we do is we go to the upper left-hand corner, and you're going to see we have the name here. All I have to do is just click in here, and then I can go and change the name. So what I'm going to do is change this to Take a Break, instead of just Take Break. So now we can see it says Take a Break. Now it didn't save this name yet. What I need to do to save this name is hit Return. So you want to make sure that you hit Return after you change a name. So I'm going to hit Return, and now it saved that name. Well, what about the color and the icon? Well, if we go over to the left, you're going to see we have the icon here, and it is orange. When I click on this, what I'm able to do is change the color, and I can change the icon here. So let's go and change this to blue, and we're going to change this over to a moon. So now we can see we've changed that color and icon, as well as the name. Now all I need to do is just close this, and we have our new name with the color and the icon. So that's how we change the name, color, and icon with a Mac. What about the iPad and iPhone? Well, let's go over to my iPad and iPhone. We're first going to look at this on the iPad. You're going to see I'm in my Shortcuts app here, and I can see all of my different shortcuts. You're going to see Take a Break here. This is the shortcut that we've been playing around with. How do I change the name, color, and icon on the iPad? Again, I have to edit it. To edit it on an iPad and an iPhone, what we do is we go over to the three dots here. We do not double-click on the shortcut itself like we do on the Mac. That'll run it. What we need to do is click on these three dots. So I click on it, and now what I'm able to do is edit it. Again, just like the Mac, I go over to the upper left-hand corner here, and I can go and change the name. So I just click in here, and I can go and change that name. Again, you'll want to make sure that you hit Return once you change the name. To change the icon and the color, what we do is we go over to the left again, just like with the Mac, and then we click on the icon here. And now what I'm able to do is change the color as well as the icon. And again, Apple calls it a glyph. So I click on this to change the glyph. Now, unfortunately, you cannot search through these different icons. So what you'll have to do is scroll through them. But just go and select the icon you want, go and select the color, and then when you're done, you just tap on Done up here. And then you tap on Done here. Make sure you hit Enter if you change the name, and then any changes will be applied. What about the iPhone? Well, it works basically the same way on the iPhone. You're going to see I have my Shortcuts app open here, and we're going to go to the same one here. I have my Take a Break. Again, what I need to do is I need to tap on the three dots here. This allows me to edit the shortcut. And then I go up to the top here, I click in here, and I can go and change the name. Again, you want to make sure that you hit Return or Done when you're finished typing up the new name. To change the icon and the color, we go up to the icon in the upper left-hand corner. And again, I can go and change the color. Let's go and change the glyph or the icon. We're going to change it back to a timer. I go over to Glyph here. And now what I need to do is find that glyph. You're going to see that we do have them categorized down here, but I can just easily swipe to go through all of them. Again, unfortunately, you can't search for it. So I know that the timer icon is over at the end here, and you're going to see that we have the timer here. I just click on it, and now we can see that it is the timer. When I tap on Done in the upper right-hand corner and click on the X, it saves the changes. And if we look back over at my iPad, we can see that it has the timer icon in the upper left-hand corner. And when we go over to my Mac, because these are all syncing, we can see that it has the timer icon here. So that's how we can change the name, icon, and color of any one of our shortcuts on the Mac, iPad, and iPhone. Basically, what we need to do is we need to edit the shortcut. On the Mac, we double-click on the shortcut, and then we go to the upper left-hand corner and make any changes. And then on the iPad and iPhone, we tap on the three dots to edit the shortcut. If you change the name, make sure you hit Return or Done to save any changes. Otherwise, it may not save any changes that you've made when you change the name. So that's how we can change the name icon as well as the color of any one of our shortcuts on the Mac, iPad, and iPhone.